Hi, I'm Asif, Ibrahim, founder of Learners Conclave.
How many of you all are leaders?
Hey, well, let me go ahead and start off our show, Coffee with TF. And let me go ahead and introduce you to the moderator and the host of today's show, Mr. Anurag Patankar, a corporate trainer, a motivational speaker, a life coach, a certified career mentor, a certified CBT and NLP practitioner, a certified life coach, a meditation practitioner, and an international trainer on speed reading and memorizing. And apart from that, he is also the founder of two beautiful ventures, the first being Columbia Maxim, which deals with corporate trainings, TTTs, career counseling, soft skills, parenting, speed reading, and mind mapping. And the second one is DVP Ventures, which deals with finance, which is a finance consultancy. Now, there is still so much to go ahead and read about Anurag, but I think, like, you know, we'll eat up most of our time just reading that. And we are great to have Asif over here. So without any delay, let me go ahead and give the show over to Anurag, where he can lead us in, like, you know, getting us to know more about Asif and helping us to go ahead and learn a lot of nuggets of wisdom from him. There you go, Anurag. Show is yours.
Thank you. Firstly, I would like to thank Paul for giving me such a great opportunity to host this interview for such a wonderful and dynamic personality. I appreciate Training Frat for doing this amazing work. So friends, I'm Anurag. Before we start, I would like to give a short introduction of our today's guest. He is the founder of Learners Conclave, the world's biggest meta-education platform for trainers, coaches, and business leaders. Learners Conclave helps leaders in the training world hone their skills, upgrade their marketing strategies, and network more meaningfully in the training ecosystem, which includes corporates, educational institutions, and stakeholders in the personal coaching industry. Learners Conclave has pan-India reach with its roster of 10,000 soft skills and behavioral trainers and 500 HR learning and development heads who collaborate to serve the training needs of over 600 leading companies. Wow, that's fantastic. Sir, we are so glad to have you on this show.
Thank you.
There are so many things we would like to know about you. Just we all know about the successful organization Learning Conclave. But we would like to know about the founder, his journey and idea behind making this organization great.
I have a total experience of 18 years of corporate experience. I've worked at all departments. I was there into sales, into CSR, into marketing. Last corporate assignment, I was a marketing head of a company. And in 2015, December 2015, I left my job. I started a company called as ITC, International Trainers Conclave. It was a proprietorship company, my own company. And basically, I was doing learning for trainers. I used to do workshops, which I do now as well. The whole focus of the organization was learning for trainers. So I start from 2015 to 2019. These 4 years, I've done more than 200 workshops for trainers to develop their knowledge, what's happening in the learning and development world. 2019, I created this Learners Conclave, and with the sole intention, it's a private limited company, with the sole intention of learning and earning for trainers. I drink, eat, breathe for trainers. So I started connecting with a lot of corporates. I have a corporate conclave group where there are more than 500 corporate professionals. I've got learners conclave trainers group as well, where I know more than 10,000 trainers pan India. So any kind of training requirements from the corporate, I connect to the right kind of trainers. And Elroy, and now building a team as well. I have Elroy, Melisha, and as an employee as well. So they take care of whenever there's a requirement, we try to source the right kind of trainers to the right kind of corporate. This was my journey.
Wow, that's amazing and it's so inspirational. And because I actually appreciate a lot of people leave their job and start their own ventures. Really, it's very, very inspirational. So we would like to know how you tap people, corporates to offer your services. Because what happened, most of the cases, people and some organizations struggle to enter into corporates. And how that happened, and how can we as a trainer can achieve this twist?
So what happens is, in this world, if you ask me 1 year back, I knew only 39 organizations. And in 1 year, one and a half years, from 39, I have moved to 500 plus organizations. So how is it possible that, you know, you reach out to so many organizations? You don't have to reach out to so many organizations. You have to do certain things in a certain way that they will reach out to you. You have, whoever you connect, whether you have connect with an HR head, L&D head, or anyone in your life, try to see how you can help that person. If you are able to help that person, they will be there with you for a long period of time. What most of the trainers do is, whenever they reach out to or they meet any HR head or L&D head, they start promoting their business. They start giving their cards to them and start asking for business from them. If you do these things, they'll run away from you. There are thousands of other trainers as well, you know, meeting them and giving their cards to them. You have to first build a relationship with them and try to see what you can do for them. Of course, they will take care of you, but you have to start something. You know, you have, first of all, be visible. Be visible. Most of the trainers are not even visible as well in platforms. LinkedIn, Facebook, Insta, YouTube, be visible. Let the world see what kind of work, what you do. And if you're consistent, if you see my profile, Facebook and LinkedIn, at least 4 to 6 times a day I post. I'm that visible. As well as reach out to more number of HR, L&D professionals. I don't reach out to people to see, you know, what they can do for me. I reach out to them to understand what I can do for them. So it's all about your thought process. And very soon, maybe another 3 years, you'll find 5,000 corporates reaching out to me. Because it's all about what I can give them. If I'm able to give them, they will give back to me.
That's great. So, I mean, I just wanted to, I mean, ask you a certain thing. So, what is that Asif Ebrahim as an individual would like to convey our training fraternity?
First of all, I give them a framework. You have to understand the whole training industry as a whole. And then you'll do, what happens is, first is, I'll share how this training industry works and what kind of value I'm adding to them. One, there are 195 countries in this world. Out of 195 countries, India is one country with 135 crore people. Okay. First thing is, there are two kinds of people who will become successful in the training world. Who addresses a particular segment, challenges of a particular target segment. Or second, who masters one topic. It could be investor intelligence, transaction, facilitation, whatever. Either of these two. So out of, suppose, 135 crore people, you identify your target audience. Who is my target audience as a trainer? So for me, I have identified out of this 135 crore trainers as my target audience. So how many trainers would be there? Out of 135 crore people, there will be 3 lakh trainers. So I'll be working with, for these next 5 years, only for these 3 lakh trainers. I'm serving them. So if you have to be very clear, whom are you serving? Once you have defined, okay, I want to serve to this segment of society, then trainers can create their B2B and B2C services. B2B means corporates and educational institutes will buy your services. Have only 3 topics. 1, 2, 3. Don't have more than 3, because corporates, they want masters. And to master a topic, it can take 15 to 20 years if you work for 15 to 20 hours a day. So take only 3 topics for B2B. For B2C, make 4 services. The first service should be a free service. Second service should be in the range of 2,000 to 5,000. It could be a one-day workshop, it could be an online module, it could be a one-to-one session. Third service in the range of 15 to 25,000. It could be certification program, outbound program, retreat program. Fourth service in the range of 50,000 to 1 lakh. Structure these services, keep it on your website with a payment gateway so that people across India and the world, they can go and buy your services. So a lot of trainers are not even aware about these things. I share with them, this is how this industry works. you have to create your services, keep it on your website. They don't have a website as well for the world to buy your services. Then comes defining your what, why, and how. In what is the financial target what they are looking at? Whether they want to earn 5 lakhs or 5 crores. And myself, I'm building a 5,000 crore company. It's easy to make money. First, be very clear about what is the amount of money you're looking at by selling which services. What would be the, suppose this year, if I want to make 1.2 crores, I'll say 1,500 members, 5,000 rupees, 75 lakhs, 300 is the segment, 10,000 profit, 30 lakhs, 50 crores, so many people become 20 lakhs. Be very clear about whatever, how many lakhs, how many crores you want to earn. That's your what, your financial target. What should be about your target audience reach as well? Where do you stand? In LinkedIn, when I started, I knew 6 months back I started. Now it is 10,478. This year I will go to 35,000. My personal contact, when I started, I knew 19 people. Now it is 13,305. This year it will go to 1 lakh. My Facebook, my Insta, my YouTube. You should know your numbers, your what, your why. Why do you breathe? Why do you exist? Would people remember you 50 years, 100 years after your death? That why of yours? My why is learning and earning for trainers. You'll get a rejection rate of more than 95%. When Mother Teresa used to go and ask food for leprosy patient, people used to spit on her face. After spitting, she used to say, now give me food for my leprosy patient. That's the power of why. You have to be very clear about your why. And then comes how. How means, what are the actions what you'll take? Oh, I'll write 100 articles, I'll make 150 blogs, I will have 200 videos, I'll go to 50 networking events, I'll do this. Your what, why, and how, write it down hundreds of times. Each and every body cell of yours should know it. Outside world, what you get is just a reflection of what is inside. These are smaller elements, but trainers are not even aware about it. If I'm creating this awareness, it's a good, everywhere I'm creating this awareness, it's, if you don't get whatever you plan, come back and tell me, I'm there sitting out here, and I will do anything and everything for you, for trainers. But I want from there, and it's very important of efforts for that thing. Elroy, as a corporate head, he takes care of the corporate head. You can send your profile to them, send 3 topics to them, tell them what kind of, you know, craft are you building. And I'm there with all the trainers. So this is what I'm doing for this training industry.
Wow, that's amazing and fantastic, and it is going to help us a lot, because sometimes we feel that we are, I mean, moving into a different direction, but you have given us a proper track, means it will be very useful for us. And I mean, another question I would like to ask, we would like to know, how big is your team of trainers and what are the benefits any trainer can get after associating with Learners Conclave?
What happens is, there are a lot of strategies which, you know, people should understand. At various, depending on what stage that person is. You know, I've created one product now, wherein I guarantee trainers that I'll give you assignment. Okay, there are different products, you know, I've got life membership, I've got this. It depends upon what stage of life you are into. What stage of, either you're aspiring trainer, looking out for some start, or you have 3 to 5 years of experience, wherein, you know, you have done couple of programs here and there, or you have 5+ years of experience. Depending upon what stage of life you are into, you will have to have your, you know, craft ready. Okay, craft ready. An aspiring trainer, first he needs to have that knowledge. You know, I have created a huge bank library, Learners Conclave library, wherein entire lifetime, if a trainer goes to that library and wants to read that material, it won't get over. Entire lifetime. Such a huge library with presentations, videos, modules, ebooks. It's huge. It's not that I have created this. I know thousands of trainers pan India. They share a lot of material with me. Presentations, videos, modules. So all that I've collated and kept it into the library. What I tell people is, go to that library, download all the material what you like, and build up your own content bank so that you can post at various platforms. And people can look up to you as an authority for that domain or topic. So one is that library which I built, which they can get access to that library. Second, whatever workshop they have their workshops, which they are promoting, they can share that workshops with me. I will promote it to the all the corporates and everywhere I will promote it. And I just don't want anything. I just want 10% for my this thing, my service charges, as well as 10% discount to my Learners Conclave members. 10% discount to them. So they get everything. Only thing is I can also guide how this, how you get workshops, open participants for your open workshops. What are the things to that? Because I've been doing workshops for the last 4 or 5 years. It's been more than 200 workshops. Now also today is the last day of an emotional intelligence workshop. It was a 5-6 days workshop, 2 hours each for last 5-6 days. Today is getting over. So for that, there are 21 participants for that batch as well. We were doing offline. Now we have started online. But every workshop batch is full. Every batch is full. So I can share a few insight of why I'm able to do these kind of workshop and all batches full. So you have to keep on working. People who are ready to put in their work and want to build a brand, then they should associate. I can share all the steps. One, I can give them all corporate assignments. I can give them library. I can expose them to corporates. You can write blogs at my Learners Conclave website. Will be shared with the corporate. Anything and everything for the trainers to build their brand in the training industry.
It is always better to have a mentor behind you to show a proper direction in life. That's fantastic. So all participants in the show are waiting to interact with you. So we just opened the session for Q&A slot. Saurabh, you can ask your question, please.
Good evening, Asif. I had been waiting for this opportunity to talk to you personally because I've heard so many things about you. And it's good and really to meet you personally in future also. Do you see what all things we need to rectify in ourselves, change something so that we can sustain ourselves in this pandemic? Or after that also, after the effects of pandemic?
Now things have changed. To be very frank, things were different before this corona and things are completely different after this corona. So for this pandemic, what we need to understand is the day we got to know that this happened maybe 2 months back, that day itself I started my core online business was zero. To be very frank, online business was zero. I was not present online with anything. But I started 1.5-2 months back when we got to know that, you know, you can't do anything now. And that we started with corporate webinars. We started with a lot of, you know, every day. For 30 days, we gave opportunity to 30 trainers to share their knowledge. And we exposed it to a lot of corporates. And these lot of trainers got assignment from a lot of... So now be more visible. The first is visible online. All trainers have to be visible online. At least in all platforms, share 2 to 4 times. At least in Facebook and LinkedIn, these two platforms and YouTube videos, if you want to be a motivational speaker, or you have some content to share, you can create 4-5 videos a week as well. Be visible and don't worry about, you know, what people will say. And if you know, it's too much, it's not too much. You have to understand where do you stand, where do you want to go. If you ask me right now, my presence is 13,306. I want to reach out to 3 lakh trainers. That from 13,306 to 3 lakh, I need to bridge that gap. So that's the reason I post 4 to 6 times a day. So be visible, write good stuff, help your target audience grow, you will automatically grow. Don't worry if people do not understand you. They will reject you left, right and center. They won't buy your services. But keep doing, don't stop. And whenever you feel low, call me up and I'm there for you.
Oh, thank you, Asif.
Okay. Now we have Sujita. Sujita, you can ask next question.
So I have seen you working day and night, and you post on Group Learners Conclave in early in the morning, and you are active till late night. So I just wanted to know, or I was wondering how you place your day, the time management, something which I would like to take insight on that.
Okay. What happens is I'll share a couple of more things before sharing. What happens is there's nothing called as balance of work-life balance, to be very frank with you. Okay. There's nothing called as work-life balance. I spoke to my wife 6 months back. First of all, your family support you should have. I spoke to my wife 6 months back. I told her, I want to build a huge organization, and my organization is very small right now, and it will require commitment. And give me some time. I will be there available with you for some time, but most of the time I'll be working. She said, yes. And then I'm putting all my work. I'm working more. I'm compelled, and very few things, you know, wherein I'm required, I take care of that. Otherwise, most of the time I'm working from morning 5 a.m. till evening 12. Second after second, you can ask me any second of my life. Three things you have to do every second of your life. One, read in your domain. Second, share at various platforms. Third, connect with your target audience and make a difference in their life. If you work, you have two options. Try to balance your life and work for 20, 30 years. Or 2-3 years, focus on your work, build a huge organization, and then your team can take care of everything. Then you have some time to breathe. Initially, when you start, you won't be able to do, you know, take care of, because there are a lot of departments. Every trainer need to understand that they are an organization. Every trainer is an organization. There are 7 departments of an organization, and every department you need to work upon. The first, the marketing, you have to understand how many leads are you getting every week or every month. That marketing department does it. So you write your name as your name. Second, your sales, how many closures what you have. Third, operations, all that. You can ask me one-to-one, I can share all the details. But yeah, this is how it works. Personally speaking, I'm focusing more on work. But I have taken that calculated call. It's not about do this much. It's like driving from Mumbai to Pune. If you tell me there is 180 kilometer, the distance will remain the same. If you drive at 60 kilometer, you will reach in 3 hours. But if you drive at 5 kilometer, you will reach later. Nothing, no, there's no, that's fine. It's your call. Whether you want to reach late, you want to reach in 3 hours, you want to reach whatever. But drive safe and then you will reach. 60 kilometer is good enough, 3 hours is good enough. But if you want to reach in, you want to drive, either you do it or get it done from someone else for every action of yours.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Sir,
I want to just ask you one question. In a startup, what things should a trainer should keep in mind before launch a product?
First of all, it all depends upon when you're starting up as a trainer. Why? Your why matters. First, you have to understand, why do you want to start? What made you think that I want to get into training? That your why is very critical. If your why is very strong, you will get everything. Suppose, why you want to get into training? That question, I'll keep on asking you this question, because everything will depend upon that why of yours. That why of. And whatever, once you decide to be a trainer, you should be knowledgeable. Your knowledge speaks. You know, I can go on for 10 days if you ask me questions. I can keep on answering those questions, because for last 4 years, every Saturday, Sunday, I have gone for learning, and a lot of work I've done on myself for last 3 to 4 years. So I have a lot of experiences of mine. So I have a lot of knowledge with me. So when you should have a lot of knowledge in your domain, whatever that domain is, whether it is public speaking, whether it is decision making, communication, innovation, creativity, whatever topics you want to, you should master that topic days and nights. Read a lot of books in that domain, look at a lot of process facilitation in that domain, psychometric instruments in that domain, everything. Talk to a lot of senior trainers in that domain, everything and anything. Master the craft days and nights, because when you master the craft, the world will come to you. You don't have to go to them, because you are a master. It takes time, but yes, it happens. Don't wait for things to happen. Let's make things happen. We'll do anything and everything to master our craft. And there should be an initiative for all trainers, I would say. There should be some initiative to help your target audience. You have a certain tribe of yours. Start some initiative. Start helping them. Once you start helping them, they are bound to come and, you know, take services from you. You don't have to worry about where they are buying your services. Where will they go? where will they go? Everywhere they will go, they will, someone in training industry, if you go anywhere, someone will say, go and talk to Asif. That kind of work I will do. Dekho, Amitabh Bachchan, Modi ji, all these people don't have to introduce themselves. You know, I'm Amitabh Bachchan, I'm Shah Rukh Khan, I do acting and all. Because 20 years they have given their life for their work, for their craft. After 20 years, Asif doesn't have to introduce in training industry. You know, I'm Asif, I work in training industry and this, that. I have lakhs of trainers, crores of people following me for the kind of work what I do. If you are dedicatedly, committedly working days and nights for them, of course they will know you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mo sir. Thank you so much. No sir, thank you so much. It will guide you. Thank you.
So, yeah, we are very much thankful to you for giving your valuable time and made our days so productive by sharing very, very useful learning. So we have so many people who actually wanted to ask you questions, but we had a lack of time. Actually, we don't have that much time to pick up everybody's questions. So I suggest everybody to just post your questions on YouTube channel. And for that, you need to subscribe our channel. That is a Training Frat. And you just, if you have any doubt, any queries, you can just, question in the comment section and you will be rewarded by the sir. And it's over to Paul. I mean, if you would like to speak anything else.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much, Asif. It's been a wonderful time. I mean, like, you know, I can just simply say one thing. Like, you know, I know one thing. I don't know why Asif is not saying this today. But then I know one thing that Asif always says, one thing that he doesn't, like, you know, train. Training is not a word for him. He breathes training. So training is literally like, you know, unke liye saas hai. So then... Every time when I used to talk with Asif, every time, wherever you may be, the first thing which comes out of his mouth is, I breed training. So we could see training in and out. And in fact, today, Asif has actually come up with a statement like, you know, I mean, he could literally tell us how committed he is to the cause. And I'm so grateful for the training industry to have such a kind of a person like Asif amongst us. Thank you so much, Asif. You are an inspiration to each and every one of us.
Wish you all the best. Be crazy for your dreams. India is one country, 194 other countries are waiting for you. Be passionately, madly in love with what you do. And I'm there. Just give me a call for any kind of help. I'm there. I can guide you. I can tell you these are the things, elements. Don't stop. Let the world do what they want to do with you. But please don't stop. Keep doing what you're doing.
There you go, guys. Asif has given an open invite to each and every one of you to come, to learn, to call him, to learn from him and be the best in the industry. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much, Anurag, for moderating the show. You're an amazing guy.
My pleasure.
Thank you, Asif. Yeah. Thank you.